Brent Venables appears to be the guy, Chris. I went on the show on Monday and said that I had been told that it's Venables, period. That there is really no other option. They're doing their due diligence, but that it would be Brent Venables at the end of the day. And this morning, of course, it's not official, it's whatever, but all of the big name people that you would normally expect are saying that it's going to be Brent Venables at Oklahoma. Does that surprise you that they would go a different direction than an offensive guy like Lincoln?
No, it doesn't surprise me. And I don't know that some of these ADs pay that much attention to this stuff. I think we in the media try to make storylines, and these guys are just trying to hire the right guy for the job. And I don't know that they care that the last guy that was really successful was a defensive guy and his first head coaching job. And then we had an offensive guy and his first head coaching job. So now let's go to a defensive guy again. Like, I don't know that anybody pays attention to that when you're an AD. I think it's just so damn hard to hire somebody good.
I agree with you. And the rumors are, of course, are not necessarily rumors. It appears that it is a package deal. He's going to bring Jeff Lebby back to Oklahoma. Jeff Lebby, of course, the offensive coordinator under Lane Kiffin at Ole Miss. And it's not super shocking. Lebby was one of the guys, I believe, when he was at Baylor, or maybe it was Texas Tech. I don't remember where he was, but he got caught spying on Oklahoma from the opposing sideline at one point. So it was questionable, but at the end of the day, Lebby went to school at Oklahoma. He played at Oklahoma going home. I mean, you can't fault a guy for doing that, especially if the money is going to be similar or more. So Baylor, that's what it was. Gary said, Gary Lewis jumped in and said it was Baylor. So yes, you know, it's not shocking to me that he would go back to Oklahoma, especially under a defensive coach that is going to somewhat give him free rein on the offense, I would believe. So we'll see. That's kind of what Venables has done at Clemson. He was the DC for forever, and Dabo just let him handle the defensive side of the ball. I would imagine the same thing will go in here. Hires in an OC. He's going to let him handle the offensive side of the ball. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter, at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com, or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.